Shalom. All praise Yahweh, Ba Hashem Yahweh Shai, Waha Raka Kwedash. I want to give double honor to my teachers, the apostles, and elders of the Great Millstone. Also, peace and blessings to my fellow yokesmen, the hopeful elect that continue in the work of our Lord and our Savior, Yahweh Shai. Also, to the brothers and sisters that continue to believe upon the names Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, in all fear, Shalom. Lord willing, this lesson will be edifying. This lesson is entitled, Love Worketh No Ill Unto His Neighbor. And that is roughly paraphrased from the book of Romans, chapter 13 and verse 10. Love worketh no ill to his neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law. And pertaining to the act that our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, committed by giving himself up to the cross and shedding his blood upon the cross, first for the elect of the nation of Israel. Therefore, Israel as a whole can be saved through the elect being covered by the blood of the Savior, which is Yahweh Shai. And by that act, Yahweh Shai showed real love. Now, the scripture tells us in the book of St. John, chapter 15, and verse 13, it says, I'm going to start at 12. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Now, when we examine what Yahweh Shai is speaking of, Yahweh Shai is not speaking of that physical love, all right, that the world deems as real love. Yahweh Shai is speaking of that spiritual love, because the love that Yahweh Shai gave us was the same love that was given unto Yahweh Shai by his Father. And that's the Most High, Yahweh Ba Hashem Yahweh Shai, giving the instructions to Yahweh Shai and putting all things in the hand of Yahweh Shai. And Yahweh Shai, being that loyal and faithful servant of the Most High, he completed the task at hand, which was to come and to be a servant of the Most High by doing the will of the Most High, and not just doing the will, but completing the will. That's how Yahweh Shai became perfected. That's why he is glorified at the right hand of the Most High. Okay, now that same love that the Most High gave Yahweh Shai gave himself up to the cross and shed his blood for the elect of the nation of Israel. Therefore, the things that Yahweh Shai was permitted to know, he gave to the elect, which are the secrets of the Most High. That's real love, all right? That's spiritual love. Now, 13 tells us, greater love have no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Okay, so Yahweh Shai laid down his life for his friends, all right, which are the elect of the nation of Israel, those that are dear to the Most High's heart, because Yahweh Shai's mission was come to be the sacrificial lamb and to come and die for those that was dear to the Most High's heart, which is the elect. And Yahweh Shai completed that by laying down his life, which is giving himself up to the cross, all right, which is no greater love. Verse 14, it says, ye are my friends if ye do whatsoever I commanded. Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth, but I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father I have made known unto you. See that? So that's that love that we have received, all right, from Yahweh Shai. All the things that was permitted for Yahweh Shai to know, all right, through to the Spirit, being upon Yahweh Shai as being that faithful servant, Yahweh Shai gave himself up to the cross, and through the Spirit and mercy of the Most High, he's allowed that Spirit to come upon us, and that Spirit, which is the Spirit of Yahweh Shai, the comforting Spirit, has supped with our spirit and let us know deep, dark secrets, showing us that real love. Now, the book of Isaiah, chapter 53, is an example of Yahweh Shai, all right, giving himself up to the cross. Isaiah 53 and verse 4, it says, surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did not esteem him, or we did esteem him stricken, smitten of the Most High, and afflicted. So let's read that again. Isaiah 53 and 4. Surely he have brought, brought means carry, our griefs. Okay, and that's what Yahweh Shai have done. He have carried our griefs and carried our sorrows. All right, pertaining to us breaking the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. And sin was put upon us. It says, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of the Most High, and afflicted. All right, verse 5. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. He was bruised for our sin. All right? He was wounded for our transgressions. It says, the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. And that's right. All the things that Yahweh Shai went through, the elect of the nation of Israel have a chance to be saved due to Yahweh Shai laying down his life for those that are dear to the heart of the Most High, which is the elect. Therefore, the nation of Israel as a whole can be saved. Okay? And as the scripture tells us, this Yahweh Shai did once. Hebrews 7 and 27. It says, who needed not daily as those high priests, meaning Yahweh Shai being a high priest, and need not to do things on a daily basis as the other high priest did, which is give sacrifices. Yahweh Shai was given a body that was fit to be the sacrificial lamb. So who needed not daily as those high priests to offer up sacrifice, first for his own sins, first for Yahweh Shai's sins in his past life, such as King Solomon, such as Adam, and then for the peoples, which is the elect of the nation of Israel. For this he did once when he offered up himself. So when he gave himself up for the cross, he did this once. First for his sins and then for the elect's sins. Lord willing, we be a part of that number. Therefore, the nation of Israel can be saved as a whole. That's why Yahweh Shai has been glorified. All right? And that love that Yahweh Shai have shown worketh no ill, worketh no bad time, all right, unto the servants. Lord willing, we be made friends of the Most High. Revelation 5 and verse 1, it says, and I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside sealed with seven seals. And that's the scriptures. Verse 2, and I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof? Verse 3, no man in heaven nor in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to loose thereon. So no man on the earth or in the heavens, all right, was able to loose these seals or to look thereon, meaning read this book and break it down in its purest form. Verse 4, and I wept much. So by knowing this, John of Patmos is crying bitterly. Weep means to cry bitterly. Why? Because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. Verse 5, and one of the elders said unto me, weep not. So don't cry bitterly. Behold, behold means see or look. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, hath prevailed to open the book. So Yahweh Shai gave himself up to the cross and shed his blood, completed the mission of the Most High. So he carried off the victory. Prevailed means carry off the victory. It says, and to loose the seven seals thereof. So the victory was won by Yahweh Shai shedding his blood. So these mysteries can be what? Revealed unto us. So we can have a chance for salvation. See that? That's real love. That worketh no ill unto its neighbor. All right? The neighbors being the brotherhood. All right? Which is the Israelites, the so-called Negroes, on down to the so-called Mexicans. Verse 6. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst meaning middle or amongst, of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb as it was slain. So Yahweh Shai is that lamb, that sacrificial lamb, all right, that was given a body fit for sacrifice, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of the Most High sent forth into all the earth. And he came and took the book, which is the scriptures, out of the right hand of him that sat upon the throne, which is the Most High, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, the Father of spirits. Verse 8, and when he had taken the book, the four beasts and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having every one of them harps and golden vials full of odors, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sung a new song, saying, Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to the Most High by thy blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation. So now we're able to sing that new song due to Yahweh Shai, all right, being that sacrificial lamb and became that sacrificial lamb, which was slain, all right, and through his blood, we have been freed from sin. We have been redeemed. We have been bought back, okay? Verse 10, and have made us unto our power kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth. So by Yahweh Shai's bloodshed, we are being made kings and priests. We are being made cleansed in the sight of the Most High. We have a chance for salvation now. And that's due to Yahweh Shai showing true love. All right? That worketh no ill unto his neighbor. Let's read that again. Romans 13 and verse 10. It says, love worketh no ill to his neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law. Galatians 5 and 14 tells us, it says, I'm going to start at 13, Galatians 5 and 13, for brethren, all right, and that's a separation. The Israelites, starting with the elect, ye have been called into liberty. Liberty means freedom. Only use not liberty or freedom for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. So the things that the Most High allowed Yahweh Shai to know and Yahweh Shai allowed us to know due to his bloodshed, all right, we should spread that love to others, all right? Number one, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, on down to the so-called Mexicans, which is the brethren, the Israelites, beginning with the elect, and the rest of the heathen nations, beginning with the wicked, the so-called modern-day white race, beginning with the top-tier elites, all right? We should give them love by telling them they is the wicked that the Bible speaks of. Their kingdom is going to go down. They're going to get destroyed by the coming of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. They're going to get done away with. They're going into captivity. That's us showing love, all right, to our enemies. The rest of the heathen nations, you're going to be under our feet. You're going to be ruled by righteousness. That's love that we have unto them. The love that we have to the brethren, the Israelites, we're telling them that this kingdom, which is wickedness at its finest, is going to be over with. You are the true powers of the Most High. All right? Salvation is on the way. Verse 14, for all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. And that's what we're doing. All right? Coming in the footsteps of Yahweh Shai, completing the work, Lord willing, which is to continue in that love, all right, which is to what? Teach, which is to warn, which is to build up the nation of Israel, all right, for that righteous day, which is the day of the Lord. And that's the coming of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. So, you know, Lord willing, I pray that this lesson made sense and that this was edifying. Shalom.